The Honorable Chief Guest of the Function, Professor Faulkner, my friend and colleague Professor A.K. Misra, the Head Department of Business, Mizoram University, Dr. M.P. Singh, the Executive Secretary of the School of Management Sciences, the Director of the Institute, Professor P.N. Jha, the conveners, Dr. R.K. Singh and Dr. Kamal Seel Misra, my colleague, Professor Bhandari, the Assistant Dean of Pokhara University Management Faculty, my friend, Dr. N.B. Singh, equally distinguished guests sitting off the dais, the delegates who have come from different institutions, from different part of the country, and a few from abroad also, ladies and gentlemen, I deem it an honor and also a privilege to be the part of the inaugural function of the two-day national conference on skill development. At the very outset, I would like to thank the School of Management Sciences for giving me an opportunity to be the part of this wonderful academic event and to share some of my reflections on skill development, bridging the observed skill gap. I would also like to congratulate the School of Management Sciences for selecting such a contemporary and vital issue for this conference. And the reason is very obvious, because the shortage of appropriately skilled labor force across many industry in India is emerging as a very strong challenge to the growth and future of the country. I would like to begin with Dr. P.N. Jha's welcome address. The wisdom is the underlying essence of any activity on the earth. So I am reminded of a small poem. Where is the life we have lost in living? Where is the knowledge we have lost in information? And where is the wisdom we have lost in knowledge? A reference was made that we are passing through the knowledge-driven economy. And to me, it appears that the next phase will be the wisdom-driven economy. And once we enter the wisdom-driven economy, perhaps aligning the corporate goal with the social objective will become more important. Dr. Rajkumar, the convener, while outlining the theme, he was making a reference of the population dividend. Yes, the India does have has a population dividend because of a large percentage of young population. But my friends, this population dividend will be a real dividend only when the people of India are equipped with the contemporary skills. Otherwise, it will not remain. Recently, a survey was conducted by NASSCOM, and that survey reveals that about 3 million postgraduate and undergraduate are added to the labor force every year. But unfortunately, only 25% of technical graduates and 10 to 15% of non-technical graduates, they are considered to be employable by the industry. So now we are having a growing skill gap, which is clearly reflecting the slim availability of the quality college graduates. And this is not only true for India, this is a phenomenon across the world. A recently conducted study reveals that large percentage of countries across the globe, they are finding difficulty in getting the people with the required set of skill and knowledge. And you will surprise to know that the percentage is 76% in Japan, 71% in Brazil. In United States of America, it is 49%, and in case of India, it is 48%. Think of when the 50% business is 49, 50, 48, 50% of businesses are functioning without adequate manpower. So how to achieve that goal? That is a difficult proposition. On the other hand, the global economy recession has given birth to a different kind of world. And there, now we are coming out of that phase. The businesses in India, they are proposing to increase their labor force in the coming future. And the corporate India is also striving to sustain its position in the global marketplace. So this is the situation. I would like to share some of the facts and some of the data which I have been able to come across. It is estimated that India would be needing 2.3 million employees in IT and the IT-enabled service sector in the near future. On the other hand, India has been able to produce only 1.6 million employees in this category. So it is very clear that even there is a gap of 0.7 million. And India is facing a very difficult task to produce 0.7 million IT professionals in the coming year. And in this demand supply situation, if we look at the educational system of India, you will be coming across a very interesting fact. As per the information given by the All India Council for Technical Education, the number of technical schools, including the engineering colleges, has increased threefold during the last one decade. Another fact is that only 7% of the population, of the Indian population in between the age of 18 to 25, they are going to the higher education or they are going to the college education. We find a disconnect between what is being taught at the B schools or the professional schools and what is really required by the corporate world. Many of the academic institutions, they are not able to update their syllabus to meet the demand of the fast-paced changes. And the results are very obvious. They are churning out the graduates who are not able to meet the skill requirement of the corporate world or the society. Now the corporate world is not looking only for the technical expertise or the technical knowledge. In addition to technical expertise, they are also looking for the soft skill. They are also looking for the team building capability. They are also looking at the attitudinal pattern. And more so, they are also looking for the value system of an individual. So what is the scenario now? If the academic institutions are not able to fulfill their responsibility of churning out the graduates who could come up to the expectation of the industry, so the industries are coming themselves forward. They are intensifying their academic interventions. So what has happened, recently, the Infosys, they have started a program called Campus Connect. And the basic purpose of this program is to align the college education to the corporate requirement. The Wipro Technologies has also come with an innovative kind of program that is known as the Wipro Academy of Software Excellence. And through this program, they are intending to create a good band of competent, talented software engineers. Recently, the Mahindra Tech, a joint venture of, you can say, Mahindra Group and the British Telecom, they have decided to enter into the education business. So these are the painful, you can say, facts. It is indicating that the corporate world is losing confidence in the quality of the college education. That's why they are deciding to come themselves into the education system. So what is this? Why this is happening? Why there is a disconnect between what is being taught at the professional institute and what is being required at the corporate work? So to me, it appears it is mainly because of a very low level of industry-academia partnership. Since I have been into management education and research for the 3 decades, so to me it appears that the basic reason of this skill gap is the low level of academia industry. You can say, why this low level of this partnership? The first thing is that, to me it appears that there is a perceptual difference between the academia and industry regarding their roles. Academia perceives that their role is just to enrich the student with the conceptual and theoretical base which are essential for doing any job. And on the other hand, the industry perceives that the quality, the quality of the graduates being churned out by the academia, they must be able to perform. So this gap is basically, perhaps this is the, you can say this perceptual difference is only because of a low level of the partnership between two. They have been able to, they have failed to understand each other's requirement. Now, a little bit of interaction and the interface is happening between the academia and the corporate world. But it is not happening in a structured way. Still, many things have to be done for this purpose. Look at the business education. When a business executive is designing or implementing any kind of program in the corporate world, he does not consult the professor of management. And on the other hand, when the professor is going for researching or making, interpreting the research results, they are not taking the help of the practicing managers. So you can say this theory and practice gap, it distances the professors who are teaching the management and also the managers who are practicing the management. So there is a need to bring these two together. Look at certain facts. The Infosys, one of the software giants in India, it is spending $5,000 for training a fresh graduate recruited by them. And they provide a training of 14 to 16 weeks just to make them job ready. On the other hand, the another software, Wipro Technologies, they are providing a training of 12 to 14 years to the fresh recruits. And on this, they are spending at 1% of their total revenue. Why this is happening so? It is happening because the passing out graduates, they are not the job ready. So that's why. And it is said that the many companies, they have started establishing or setting up their own training centers. And the reasons are very obvious. Because perhaps they are losing faith in the academic system of India. They are convinced that the academic system of India will not be able to produce the graduates up who can come up to their expectation. The Narayan Murthy of software, he says that, look, all stakeholders, governments, the corporates, the academia, and the society, they have got the equal responsibility for plugging this gap between the academic institution and the corporate world requirement. So how this academia and industry gap can be reduced? So there are many reasons. I hope that during the forthcoming various technical sessions, it will be deliberated upon. This particular issue, which is of my interest, will be deliberated upon in detail, and something will happen. Two, three things we can think of: engaging the corporate people or partnering the corporate people in engaging the classes. It is said that at least 20% of the business education classes should be given to the corporate people. Only 80% should be covered by the, you can say, the core faculty or the part-time faculty. We can also think of the faculty internship. The faculty can be sent outside for 2 or 3 months for training with the corporate world. We can also think of sending our faculty outside just to deliver talk on corporate issue to the corporate people. We can also think of involving the corporate people while designing our syllabus. Because if you look at the syllabus designing of the academic institution, particularly universities, you will find that only the academicians are involved in that process. But the time has come to involve the corporate people for whom we are preparing our graduates in the process of designing that course curriculum, etc. What I wanted to convey is that this gap, because we cannot allow this gap to be widened. Otherwise, the society will be filled with a pool of unemployable graduates, and those unemployable graduates will become a liability for the society. So there is an emergent need to relook into this whole system, and we have to find ways and means how the industry academia gap can be reduced, it can be plugged, it can be bridged. With these words, I hope that the forthcoming technical sessions will deliberate not only on this issue, but they will also be deliberating on the different issues, and towards the end